When the current pandemic was still in its early stages, many in F1 had predicted that some of the teams in F1 would struggle to stay afloat. One team that would often be mentioned in these predictions was Williams. They would eventually lose its title sponsor, and now one of the founders of the team has given his thoughts on the dire situation at Williams. I'm your host, Dylan Shelley, and first up on Formula World, co-founder criticises leadership at Williams. Co-founder Patrick Head began by getting straight to the point by suggesting that a team in F1 cannot stay viable by finishing last all the time. You can't run an F1 team and keep your head above water while consistently finishing 10th. For this year, it's crucial that they come back and hunt for better spots. I'm not naive and I don't think they're going to fight for the podium, but I hope they can at least get into the low midfield spots. He concluded by implicating that the lack of strong leadership has been the cause of this backward slide. There are quite some fantastic employees over there. On the technical front, they have unfortunately had a series of not too strong leaders. The difference lies in that. They need strong technical leadership. We shouldn't waste energy on driver talks. While many of the teams in F1 have already finalised their driver lineups for 2021, Alfa Romeo has been very quiet regarding their plans. Team principal Frederic Vasseur explained why this is the case. We're in a different situation. We always make our decisions between October and November. We will not change that. I want us to focus on the races first. We have to deliver this year because it's important for next year because of the prize money. He summed up his words by speaking about one of his drivers, Antonio Giovinazzi. We shouldn't waste energy on it. We are satisfied with our drivers and have confidence in them. Antonio is improving. He had a good second half of the year in 2019. We will definitely have a good driver pairing again in 2021. We'll talk about that later. Now is not the time. Fast feed. Williams has revealed its new livery for 2020. Renault's F1 managing director Cyril Abitbol has revealed that the upgrades for races 3, 5 and 6 from Vietnam, the Netherlands and Barcelona will be on their car in Austria. He also wants to downplay any expectations because their car was really, really bad last year. His driver Esteban Ocon added to that by saying it's going to be a hell of a data gathering exercise on Friday to see where they've improved, how everything is going to feel. Red Bull's Alex Albon thinks that it's good for everyone to get used to the new COVID-19 protocols, and it's been pretty seamless for him and his team. According to his team principal, Christian Horner, to have a day that is well spread and to do those 100 kilometres, albeit on show tyres, is something he can take to Austria and take advantage of. Red Bull team advisor Helmut Marko has revealed that the only race outside Europe that is currently fixed is, remarkably enough, China. He also feels that they have to lead from the start, be aggressive, but added they can't afford to retire if they only have 8 races at the end. Lewis Hamilton feels that to drive past empty grandstands just isn't that inspiring, that's going to be a bit lonely. McLaren CEO Zak Brown thinks that they will have up to 16 races in 2020, 18 will be very difficult. He also thinks that it is good because for a long time it was thought there wouldn't be a season at all. Alfa Romeo team principal Frederic Vasseur thinks that with a field that's closer together, if everything goes well in a weekend, you could also achieve good results as a small team. He also feels that including driver salaries in the budget cap could be an option. The advantage would be that teams would then invest more in young drivers. Sports director of Ferrari, Laurent Mekies, has revealed that for the guys in the garage, it's really hard to wear a mask all the time. He further added that they will do everything they can to work safely as possible and there will be no possibility to have a little more freedom in it. The protection is just the norm. Former F1 champion Mika Hakkinen is of the opinion that we may be only driving 15 Grand Prix. If you win the title in such a short season, you have to excel in all aspects, talent, concentration, fitness and adaptability. He also feels that Max sees his chance, is going to attack at full speed and is willing to take big risks, and is wondering if all drivers are ready for Max's driving style after this long break. FIA President Jean Todt thinks that it's very unfair to attach blame to what happened in Australia as things were moving so quickly. Director of the Circuit of Americas, Bobby Epstein, has revealed that they are not there yet, but is assuming that F1 will come. And AlphaTauri's Daniel Kvyat thinks that Imola is a track which is really nice to drive with lots of fast corners and thinks that it deserves to return to the F1 calendar. Do you agree with Patrick Head? Has William lacked strong technical leadership? Head over to my community page to vote in the poll and let me know what you think in the comments. And if you like this video, feel free to subscribe and check out my others for all the latest in the world of Formula One.